and welcome to Smita's Kitchen. Today I'm going to make cauliflower au gratin or baked cauliflower for you. This is a very fancy dish which takes minimum amount of cooking and but it tastes really good and it's healthy too. What we're gonna do is we are gonna cook the cauliflower florets in a cheese sauce and then bake it topped with a lot more cheese and we'll bake it to perfection. What I have over here are some cauliflower florets, which you can take roughly one head of cauliflower. I have cut them into florets and washed them and kept them aside. Now traditionally, cauliflower au gratin is only made with cauliflowers, but I also use some other vegetables with it. You can use beans, carrots, peas. I have some beans and peas over here. You can also avoid it if you don't want it and you just want to cook with cauliflower, that's also fine. So what I've done is I have washed and cut all the vegetables, cut them into big pieces and then just keep them aside. What we are going to do is we are going to steam them lightly and then cook them in some cooker, a little bit of cheese sauce, and we are going to bake them together. So I am going to tell you the other ingredients that we are going to need for this. Over here, I have 1 cup of milk, 1/2 cup of coconut milk, I have some butter, 2 tablespoons of corn flour, I have some garlic chopped over here, roughly around 10 cloves of garlic should be. And I have 2 types of cheeses, so we use a lot of cheese in cauliflower au gratin. And I have used 2 types of cheeses. I have over here cheddar and mozzarella, which I have shredded and just kept aside. And with this, we are going to use these spices. So I use a small teaspoon of nutmeg powder, a teaspoon of cinnamon powder, and I'm going to use some dried oregano. If you have fresh oregano, nothing like it, but I don't have that, so I'm going to use some dried oregano in this. Now, since this is a very cheesy dish, and there's a lot of white sauce and cheese that goes into it, butter, cheese, milk, coconut milk, and everything has a little bit of tone of sweetness under it. So I have a secret ingredient that I add onto it, which gives the cauliflower au gratin its zing, a little bit of kick in the taste. And that is, I use a bit of Tabasco sauce, just a tiny bit of it into the sauce that I make. That gives it that extra hit, the extra zing in the cheesy sauce. Now let's get started. What I'm gonna do is, I'm going to lightly steam the cauliflowers. I have some water over here. I'm not going to boil them completely. They should be very lightly steamed, just enough so that I can, because they will be baked again for 20 minutes. So before that, I just want to steam the vegetables to some amount. Don't boil them completely. That's why I'm not using a traditional cooker. I'm just going to steam them lightly. Then I'm going to strain them and then we will layer it for baking. So let's do this. The water has come to a boil. Now I will add my cauliflower florets into it. Be careful while doing this, because it's hot water. I'm going to add all the vegetables, and as I said, I'll slightly steam them and then strain them. We don't need the water of this, so you can throw away the boiled water. Don't overcook it. Cover this up with the lid and let it come to a boil. And while this cooks, we can make our cheese sauce. So let's get started with that. So now we are going to make the cheese sauce while the vegetable is steaming. I'm going to use a little bit of olive oil. Now the trick with cooking with butter is that you should use some oil also with it, because if you use butter only, then it will get burnt out. You can use olive pomace oil, which I use. So I'm just going to get started on this. Heat up your pan and add roughly a small teaspoon of olive oil, and then this is the butter. Be generous with the butter. flame on low. We don't want to burn this. Once the butter has melted, we will add the chopped garlic to it. Let it slightly brown. Now, to thicken up the sauce, to make the white cheese sauce, you can also use refined flour or maida. I'm going to use corn flour. So basically, this is used to give it a binding. The sauce gets a little binding effect with either refined flour or corn flour, whichever you prefer. Sit around, don't let it stick, don't let it burn. Keep the flame at low, you don't want to burn this up. I'm going to add my spices into it. As I said, I have salt, pepper, nutmeg powder, little bit of cardamom powder in this. Use white pepper or black pepper, whichever you prefer. And if you don't want it to be spicy, you can avoid pepper, but I would suggest add it a little bit because it gives a good taste to it. Now keep the flame on very low. And now we are going to add some of our cheese to it. Almost half of what I have here. The rest of it I'm going to use when I'm going to bake this. Keep the flame on low. If you want, you can also turn it off if you see that it's getting very hot. You can just let it melt. Let's turn it off for a little bit. While this all melts, it has to come together. I'm going to add my coconut milk. Full fat cream milk. And after doing this, just stir this continuously so that it doesn't form lumps. Heat on again. While making white sauce, or what we call the bechamel sauce, the trick is you need to keep stirring it continuously, because if you leave it, it's going to clump up and form lumps. You don't want that. Use a flat spatula like spoon, that is helpful, and a flat bottomed pan. We're not going to cook it very much, just till all the cheese melts and comes together. It has to be of a runny consistency, a little thick, so that I can pour this over my cauliflower florets. It's almost done. The cheese is yet to melt. Now the amount of cheese and butter that you're using in it can vary, and it's as per your tastes and what you prefer. If you want to decrease a little or increase the amount, that's also fine. There's no given set measurement. You can use cheddar for the sauce. It's almost done. The sauce is quite thick now. See, the milk is now coming together. a little bit of oregano leaves into it. My sauce is ready and my vegetables are also steamed. Now what I'm going to do is, I'll take this off the heat, don't keep it in the heat because this will burn up. Just keep it aside and now we're going to get ready to bake this dish. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this sieve to seal this, the vegetables that are already ready, and then I'm going to bake them in this baking tray. I'm going to line them up and bake this. So let's get this done. This is a ceramic dish that I'm going to use for baking. This can go into microwave oven and in convection mode. We are going to bake this at convection at 220 degrees for roughly around 20 minutes. So this is my baking tray. You can use a metal tray also or ceramic, whichever you prefer. Basically something which you can use in the convection mode of oven. If you have a traditional oven, then fine. If you have a microwave oven, which we normally have in our homes, then we need a convection proof dish. You can get borosil dishes or like this one, this is a ceramic dish. And I'm going to do this. These are my steamed vegetables. I'm going to layer them up. Spread them around evenly. You don't have to worry about it. Because as you can see, it is a little cooked. It's not completely cooked, but it's coming off because we'll still bake it. We didn't want it to be completely soggy, but as you call it, al dente. This is slightly cooked. This is done. I've layered it like this. Now I'm going to top it with my cheese sauce. It's going to come together. Cover it up. Now, Tabasco sauce are really spicy and it has a very, it just hits you. So be very careful while using it, and if you have kids, you're going to feed it, probably you should avoid it. I have green Tabasco and red Tabasco both. I'm going to use a very little amount of it and just sprinkle a little bit of it on it. Just a few drops of it should do the trick. Don't overdo it, it's really spicy. It again, it depends on your taste and what you prefer. If you prefer spicy food, then that's fine. If you don't, just avoid it because you already have added pepper into it, so that should provide the spice also. But as I said, since this sauce is very cheesy, I like to have a little bit of Tabasco on it. Now that this dish is layered, what we are going to do is, this is it. Now we are going to add the rest of the cheese on top. Because then once we put it on in baking, this will be crispy on the top. Spread it evenly. Once we bake this dish, the cheese on top is going to give it a crisp layer on top. Sauce that I have added, if you want, you saw what the consistency was. You can, if you want, you can keep it a little thinner also, or as thick as I can. guys, this is ready. Now we're going to put this into our microwave oven and bake this at 220 degrees for 20 minutes or 20 to 25 minutes, and it should be done by then because my vegetables are already semi-cooked, so it won't take much time. All I want is for the cheese sauce and the cheese to melt and completely cover the dish. Now the food may taste good, but it also needs to look good. So now comes the garnishing part. What you can do is, what I have over here are some breadcrumbs which I have crumbled by hand and some dried chives. You can also use spring onions, just chop them into little bits and sprinkle them on top. Or as I said, I'm going to use this breadcrumbs on top of it, very slightly, because when this gets baking, this will all become brown and crispy. And a little bit of green on top also looks good. Some spring onions, or like I'm adding some chives on top, will give that color on it, brown, green, and a little golden. So now it's all layered up and ready. So it's ready to go into the oven. Let's get baking. We are preheating the oven. We're going to preheat it, and then we are going to bake this at convection at 220 for 15 minutes. That should do it. If it's not done in 15 minutes, then we can add another 5 minutes, but 15 minutes should be enough. So let the oven preheat, and then we're gonna put the dish inside. Now it's ready. We have put the dish inside, and we are going to set it. So we're going to bake it at 220 for 15 minutes. Let's leave it at that. Our cauliflower au gratin is ready, baked to perfection. It's shiny, golden, and all ready. So let's dig in.